Hello.
Hello, Isabel. How are you?
I am doing great, Maya. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Welcome. Welcome to Candid Creoles, a segment of a celebration of Haitian excellence.
And thank
it is a
you.
Pleasure. It is a pleasure to have you here with us today. Thank you so
yes,
much.
Thank you.
Okay. And I'm going to introduce you. Maya Hippolyte is a Haitian American, and correct me if I'm wrong. That's correct.
Haitian American.
Okay. Okay, great. And Maya is an entrepreneur, and Maya is a cosmetic chemist, and you have your own business, and you live in the state of Florida in the U.S.
That's right.
Welcome, Maya.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Perfect. So first we're going to talk about you. Tell us a little bit about yourself. I believe you were born in Haiti.
Well, it's very funny, okay, because I'm one of those people who did it the opposite. That's just how life turned. I was actually born in Brooklyn, New York, okay, and at about 8 days old, I went back to Haiti, where I grew up with my grandmother. And I came back to the U.S. when I was about 19, 20 years old. So I did the exact opposite.
Yes, most of us, we start in Haiti and we come back. And then your parents did the opposite. And you were very young when you went. Wow.
8 days old, not even, maybe 5 or 8 days old.
Traveling, practically a newborn traveling.
My mom was very sick. At the time, and it was very difficult for her to handle a baby. You know what it's like when you are in a country where she was very sick. She actually had tuberculosis while she was still pregnant with me. She spent the last 2 months or 3 months of her pregnancy behind, glass in the hospital, because back then having tuberculosis was the equivalent of having AIDS. And so she still had to continue her treatments while I was still a baby, and her and my father, it was very difficult to handle that. That's how I ended up going back to Haiti to stay with my grandmother so she can get better.
Okay.
And I stayed.
And you stayed, so you were raised by your grandma, basically.
Raised by my grandmother. My mother came back to Haiti after a few years, but you know how Haitians are.
Yeah.
We have generational differences that all of the generations that raise you. So.
Yes, it's
not just your mom and dad. Everybody participates.
It's like we say, it takes a village. Haitian, it's the whole family that's the village.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yes, absolutely, absolutely. So I know you started to your business while you live in the U.S., correct?
Yes, well, actually, it's a long story. So I started my business, I was still living in Belgium. I have to give you a little bit of background. So when I came here, I was about 19 years old, and I thought that I was following what my mom told me to go learn, which was computer science. And it turns out that, because my mom was like, oh, look, your uncle, he's making so much money. You need to go and be a computer scientist. And it turns out that I did an entire year of computer science. And not only did I hate it, but I couldn't pass any classes because I hated it so much. I was the only person who couldn't learn the Pascal, the bits, the bytes, all of that. So I went back to what I actually liked, which was biology, physiology. So I did 4 years of pre-med and turned out that, okay, that was a little bit too stressful of a job for me because I couldn't handle seeing people being sick all the time. So I ended up being as a technician in a laboratory where they made Arid Extra Dry. I don't know if you've ever heard of this deodorant and antiperspirant, Arid Extra Dry, Nair Depilatory, First Response Pregnancy Test. So I worked in that company for 8 years. And I continued on to get my cosmetic science degree.
Okay.
So Then, right after I got my degree, my husband started to work for the State Department. So we got to travel. He was a consul. First, we spent 2 years in Haiti. And then after that, we went to Belgium. And that's where I was in Belgium. And we ended up getting a divorce. I spent 5 years in Belgium. And that's where the last year in Belgium, that's where I started the business. And with the three little kids that I had, I know I mentioned this to you, that I wanted to do something that would allow me to take care of my children while still making money. So that last year in Belgium, I started Morgana's Alchemy.
Great. And then I can see the sign in your background. So how did you come up with that name, Morgana's Alchemy?
Actually, it's my ex-husband that came up with the name.
Oh.
The thing is that I consider myself to be very lucky because I'm actually working in what I'm passionate about because it allows me to be creative. I'm a chemist. I still get to be a scientist, but at the same time, I'm making lotions. I'm making creams. I'm making all of those new different things that I get to try out every single day. And so I was busy calling this line Break the Hourglass. And he came in because he's American and he said, oh my gosh, you know, ever since we've been married, he had to adjust to being married to a Haitian because he would come home and he would find with my orange leaves all over my head to get rid of my headaches. <You know? laughs>
He's asking, what is that?
Yon mette ti moun yo benye, dan fey, pou yo kabye dormi.
Ni pa kopon bagay sa ou se Amerike?
I would go to Haiti and come back with all of my leaves so that I could take care of my children.
The way your grandmother taught you.
Mette yo dan benye, benye fey kou wo sol pou kalme yo. All of those things that I have learned through time, because you know, Haiti, our first thing is to go to plants. So it was a big adjustment. So Morgana's Alchemy was like, okay, you know, a thing of using plants and herbs to heal oneself.
So that's how he came up with the name. So you actually inspired him, right?
Exactly.
You said you were in Belgium for so many years. And in the last year, when you got a divorce, you wanted to stay home with your children because they were so young. So how was life in Belgium, when you started the business?
Loved it. I loved Belgium. I loved it. The only thing that was missing in Belgium was family. Because again, with three small kids, it is something that's very difficult to handle. And if it hadn't been for the fact that I had all of my family here, I probably would not have left Belgium.
Okay.
Parce que c'est vraiment un pays où il fait bon de vivre en Belgique. People are not stressed out. You know, you get your, you start out your job, you get 5 weeks vacation automatically paid. You get your, there's something that's called le pont, the bridge. So say if a holiday falls on a Thursday, this happens particularly in May. So the holiday falls on a Thursday. So you automatically get Friday off. Because
so you got a long weekend
to come back to work for just one day. And so that's what they call the pont, the bridge. That very counts. Interesting to do. So people are not as stressed as they are here in the U.S.
Est-ce que tu es retourné au Belgique?
En plusieurs fois. J'ai toujours des amis là-bas et tout ça. Donc je tiens contact et avec Facebook, Messenger, WhatsApp, maintenant c'est beaucoup plus facile.
Oui, le monde est très petit maintenant. Oui, c'est ça.
Avec mon téléphone, là, je parle à la Chine à 11h du soir. Je peux répondre parce que j'ai beaucoup de choses que j'achète de la Chine, beaucoup de produits. Et tout ça, franchement, le monde est devenu très petit avec les téléphones.
Absolument, absolument. Donc, c'est bien. Donc, tu as passé la dernière année en Belgique et tu es rentré en Floride?
En Floride, directement.
D'accord, d'accord. So, when you moved with the three young kids to Florida, so your family was there to help you, so it was easier for you to start the business?
That's right. That's okay. Right. My grandmother came directly to live with me. Again, so it was a whole thing. So not only did she help to raise me, but my children as well. She just passed away last year at 90 years old.
And so she sorry was there. To hear she that.
Got to, thank you. But she got to see my children. She was their great grandmother. Mm-hmm. She got to see and help raise my children, all three of them, until my oldest son is turning 27 now, mm-hmm. and one is turning 25, and my daughter's turning 21.
Oh, wow. They all grown.
Just died, so they're all grown, and she saw the whole thing. She saw it through with me. And, you know, again, there's always family and aunt and uncle. There's always people around.
Yeah. So she must have been so happy to be a part of your children's life.
Yes,
definitely.
Very happy.
Definitely, and
very
you
happy.
Too, and you too.
Oh yes.
Yes, absolutely. That's really beautiful. I have three children myself, so I totally understand when you have family nearby how much of a help it is, and not only just the help, it's just the connection that your children can have with your
right.
family. Yeah,
that's
it's important. Right. It's important. So being an entrepreneur, really, it's like. It takes so much time. It's like having a marriage, right? So how is
as
that?
My family tells me.
As your family tells, so your family doesn't like that you are building your own business?
Because they like that they're, at first, you know, they mean well, okay? Mm-hmm. You can't take things personal when they say things that, oh, you know, there's this job available. You're a chemist. You can be making so much money. You can this, you can that. When you just start, it's about resiliency and determination because you go through a lot of things. A lot of people think, oh, look, she's got a business. She's a millionaire. She's this, she's that. But that's not how things work. Oftentimes for the first few years, even your employees will be making more money than you do because you have to
pay them
your
first.
Employees first
yes.
before
yes.
you can pay yourself.
Yes.
And, having a business is not an easy thing. And, you know, especially being from Haiti, if you're not married, then, oh my goodness, why?
I know. I totally get it because our culture, we want to see everybody married. That's how we were raised by our parents, our aunties, our uncles. They want us, they want to see us married. And if you're so focused and married to the business, they don't understand, but they don't mean
you
well.
You can't do both. It's very difficult. You would have to find somebody who's literally like-minded as you, where, you know, okay, the business, they understand that if you are WhatsApping at 10:30 at night, they're not going to look at you suspiciously. Oh, who are you talking to? Is it a guy? Is it this? Is it that? No, I'm talking to a distributor, actually, you know.
Yeah, if you're dealing with China, which is completely a different time zone.
12 hours ahead.
Yes.
12 hours ahead. So
yes, I have a friend living in China.
Here, it's already 10:30 in the morning over there. So you need to be able to talk to them. When I am talking to some of my distributors who are in Europe, I actually have to wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning because 4 o'clock in the morning here, it's already 10 a.m. over there. And you need to be able to communicate. I mean, especially if it's your customer, you have to adjust to what their needs are. They need to talk to you. They're not going to, you can't wait until 12 o'clock in the afternoon here. It's already 6 p.m. over there, so they're going home.
Yes.
So it's the nature
of your schedule. Yes, your schedule it's fluctuates. And you have no other choice because you have all those contacts that you have to that are on different time zone, and you have to maintain them because that's part of your business. And for some relationship can get in trouble for that. You know, when one partner is always available and the other one is not because of the business. So there could be friction. Right. I have a friend of mine actually was just WhatsApping with her. She lives in China. She's in Shanghai, and she was getting ready to go to work. So right. when somebody is in a different time zone, I totally get it. And if it's part of your business, it's really a challenge to maintain the business and maintain a relationship where you can be as available as the other person wants to. You, like you said, it will have to be somebody who understands the way you work and is okay with it, basically. Mm-hmm. Yes, I totally get that. Yeah, it's not easy to be an entrepreneur. That's for sure. So I want you to tell me about the product that you sell. I know I've been at your website. It's very well done. And I wanted you to tell us about the line of products that you have.
Okay. So I started Morgana's Alchemy. This is a line of skincare. Everything that has to do with anti-aging, all of the products I personally formulate initially. I do all of the research, all of the development, and it is a line of skincare that I started for multi-ethnic market. I had a lady who was in the industry once tell me that Black women don't use product, especially anti-aging product. And being from Haiti, I thought, well, no, nothing could be further from the truth. You have no idea. And so I started out with 3 different products in the line. Mm-hmm. And now, 14 years later, we have over 30.
Oh, congratulations.
Yes, thank you.
So you have skin product. Do you have, is it only skincare or do you also have makeups?
No makeup. Okay. No makeup, because that's a completely different. It's a completely different item. Color cosmetics is very messy when you have to blend product. So that would mean that I would have to have an entire different factory in order to do color cosmetics. Okay. So yeah.
And where do you sell your product?
I sell the products online, of course. Mm-hmm. Retail, that's my store. We have done a lot of work on the website. Mm-hmm. We ship worldwide. Mm-hmm. I've got a few stores, of course, in Haiti, a couple of stores in Martinique and Guadeloupe, mm-hmm. a couple of stores in Estonia, of all places. We ship to France. We ship to Poland, and we recently got an order from Australia, which was very interesting and great.
And because Australia. So how did you get the connection in Australia? That's interesting.
I do not know. They found us on the internet and ordered from us.
Just like we were saying.
Amazing, yes.
Yeah, it's just like we were saying, with the internet and with the technology we have today, the world is really very small. We all interact with each other as if we're next door. Correct. Mm-hmm. Correct. That's great. And you also mentioned you have also some, a product that you said you have for women going to menopause, right?
Yes, I do. It's called the Venus Love Oil. So the great thing about, my experience is that in the 14 years, I have matured along with my clients. And so a lot of things that are happening to them, we have many of my clients, they have stayed with me for the entire length of the 14 years that Morgana's Alchemy has been around. And what that has done is a very privilege. So they will ask me, if there are things that are, new symptoms, if there are things that are going wrong, they will ask me if I have a product for that. So I ended up developing this love oil to help relieve women who have, of course, vaginal dryness. Mm-hmm. It can be very painful. Mm. There's a lack of hydration that happens with menopause, there's a lot of changes due to the hormonal changes that mm-hmm. happen to us, to our skin. Some people develop acne, if you can believe that, at 50 years of age, all of a sudden you have acne. There are so many things that happen. And so I developed this product specifically for women who still want to have a sexual life, but don't necessarily want to go do a lot of invasive things that will just, because hormonal treatments can be great, but then at the same time, you don't know what the side effects are. You don't know what's going on. Some people cannot do hormonal treatments because they already know that in their family that there's cancer that runs. We don't know. A very easy way to get around some of the challenges that we face.
And your clients appreciate that.
Yes, they do.
That's good. So, I know we spoke about your product lines before. So what are you wearing right now? Because your face is really glowing.
Oh my goodness. Beautiful. I did three products. I have one that's called the Paracress oil. Mm-hmm. This is a very great product that I'm starting to appreciate more and more. Paracress is a little yellow flower that actually has anesthetic properties. Okay, and from can extract, so the anesthetic properties is like a natural Botox. And what we can do is extract a substance that's called spilanthol. Spilanthol is what is that natural Botox. So it helps with the expression lines. It helps with the lines on the forehead. And specifically around here.
Okay.
So I love that. What I'm wearing right now, plus the 24K Glow, which has astaxanthin. That's a very good antioxidant. So I mix them together, and this is how I get my glow.
It sounds pretty easy because I have a friend who sells skincare product. And what because she had offered them to me recently, and then her line, like the way you take care of yourself every morning and every night, there are so many steps. And I was actually asking her, like, do you have one thing that does all of it? Or maybe two things? So it was like she said, no, but you have to use this. You have to, and I'll tell you how to do it all. So I was wondering if your line is like that.
Well, let's just say that if you want to, you can. But if you don't want to, you don't have to.
Okay.
It's just that simple. There are so many different products that address many different things. Like the one I just mentioned, the 24K Glow, it has so many ingredients that it's like an all-in-one product. That if you just want to use that one product, that's fine. However, I always tell people that the first step is to make sure that you always also cleanse. You have to have some kind of cleansing. You have to wash your face. You have to take off all of that bacteria, all of that debris. You need to remove that because we have, especially those of us who smoke, so at the very least, you need a two-step skincare.
Yes. And that's what I was telling her. I said, I guess it may not be one step. How about two steps?
You know,
but if I have six steps, I find that, okay, six, that's a lot.
It's a lot. Yeah. It's a lot. It's a lot to maintain.
Yeah.
And people don't want to do that. Although once you get used to doing it, this is something that will take you 10 minutes or less. If you're into doing a long skincare routine, once you get used to the process, you are going to, it's just going to not even take you 10 minutes in the morning or at nighttime. You know, Asian women, they allow 2 hours in the day to take care of their skin.
Oh my.
In the morning,
I heard about that.
At nighttime, okay? And people are always wondering, well, how is their skin so beautiful all the time? But they take care of it. And that's what makes the difference. You know, they don't want it. That it's part of their culture.
That's interesting to know. I didn't know that. That's interesting. So I and having you being part of Celebration of Asian Excellence is such a pleasure. So and I wanted to ask you what are your thoughts about the group? You've been with us from the beginning.
Yes, I have. And I think it's a wonderful way to unite us. We definitely need unity in order to grow. It's something that I've always seen in the Haitian community, that there's not that much unity. There's not that much encouragement of each other. Haitians, oftentimes, this is something that's now changing. I have to say, let me preface that. But it was very much lacking in the Haitian community, that we would prefer to go by anywhere else but from our fellow Haitians. We would prefer to push so many other communities, and that's not how it's done in the Hispanic community. And I think we need to mimic what they have done and align ourselves and become allies to each other and not hate each other.
I totally understand what you're saying. And then that's the whole point of starting this group, because I was saying, like, you know what, it is up to us to become one as a family. And I always say this group is a family. We are family here. And it is up to us to continue supporting each other.
Right.
And as I highlight people in the group, then we celebrate them. And I believe in energy. So we're sending good vibes, good energy, not only to them, but it comes back to us. Because what
that's
you
right.
put out comes right back to you, right?
That's exactly right.
That's my belief. So it's, and as I highlight people with businesses or without businesses, but first, with businesses, I do hope that people will support each other. If somebody has a business, they have a product that they can trust, then they go and, like, just like you said, they support the other person's business and vice versa as well.
That's right.
As we highlight in the group, and all of us also can take part in the engagement and also grow the group together, and then so we can have more people to celebrate and
that's
more
exactly right.
Yeah. So that's basically the goal. So I appreciate what you say. And how can we grow the group? If I were to ask you, give us an idea on how we can grow the group, because ultimately having this group is to change the narrative of the world on Haiti and its people. So how can we grow the group to ultimately make a difference for Haiti?
I think it's not just about highlighting. It's asking questions, asking people's opinions a lot. If it's more interactive, just ask questions, just things, and not to hesitate on going to subjects that make people uncomfortable.
The two subjects that I can think of, religion and politics. Those two subjects.
Oh my goodness, yes.
Can
yes.
really bring, like, the excitement
yes.
in the conversation.
Yes.
Yeah. So, and
I try to not talk about religion and politics, but somehow people cannot stop or get over that. That's one thing that I try to say in my company. We're not going to discuss those things. That's to each their own, because otherwise, I don't think a lot of people would be friends, especially these days.
Yes, it has been interesting lately. Like, how many people, when I'm talking to my friend, oh, I just blocked this person. Did you see that?
Yes.
Song? Yes. So did you see that
other.
Answer? They're blocking each other. And we should be able to have what I call fierce conversation. We should be able to have fierce conversations and agree to disagree respectfully. That's
yes.
how I think we should be, all of us, you know?
Yes.
And whether we're in Haiti or anywhere. Yeah. So, yeah, so it's good that you mentioned that. I was actually on the page today, and I was looking at an old post that I had asked a question from the very beginning. And I was looking at the answers and to see how did people react and answer about what can be done in Haiti, what does Haiti needs right now, which was the answers varied. So that was really interesting to read. So, and how can we elevate, like we highlight and we celebrate in the group. And then we discuss like, how can we grow, ultimately make a difference in Haiti? So how can we continue to elevate the Haitian world, the group?
The group, like I said, it's inviting people to always participate and asking the hard questions, asking the hard questions while telling them that we are open and to not come with a aggression. This is not about being aggressive towards each other. It's about having open and honest discussions that will help us to open our minds to the other side and try to understand what the other person and where that other person is coming from. Because if we cannot have open and honest discussions, then there is nothing left. We are all going to stay divided.
Okay? And, that is so true. I appreciate what you said, because context is everything. And the person's perception is entirely different than where I may be coming from. Right. And unless we keep an open mind, then we will always be fighting against each other. And therefore, how can we get better, specifically back home, if we cannot learn to unite, right? If we cannot learn to unite, that's the key. That's the key. And then, et comme on dit, notre devise, c'est l'union fait la force.
L'union fait la force.
And yet, when we unite, we're stronger, but if we do not unite, then how can we be? Another thing also I know I've had discussions like that in my own circle of friends and family, is like when we give up on Haiti, you know, it's like, oh, nothing will change. And I'm saying, no, if we all saying nothing will change, then it's going to become true. Nothing will change. But if we can say, well, what can I do where I am? It doesn't matter where you are, with what I have to make a change. And it doesn't have to be like what I'm doing here. Like when the idea came up, it's like, what can I do? And I said, okay, I'll just start a group to celebrate each other. Yes. And I don't know where it will take us, but at least I know we will know when we're in here, we love each other. And regardless of who we are. Yes.
And I have to tell you that in speaking of what can I do, I am the vice president to an association that's called Fondation Sainte-Rose de Lima. Mm-hmm. And this foundation has been around for at least 10, 15 years. One of my best friends since we were in high school together, Rachel Lefranc-Baril, is the president. Until last year, we used to have a gala every year in order to raise money for these girls who are attending Sainte-Rose de Lima. We have done countless things without people being aware or knowing. We have made a lot of differences in Haitian girls' lives, where we will pay for their tuition to stay in school. We go at Christmas time and we give them gifts. All of the proceeds always go to help these girls. And it's not just in Port-au-Prince. It's in all of the provinces where there is a Sainte-Rose de Lima school. So the little things count. So my mango butter cream that's on my website, I will usually give out 500, 1,000 pieces as gifts for the gala whenever we are having the gala, and all of the money raised usually will go for those girls that are in Haiti. And it's little things. Now, it's not making a huge dent in any way of what needs to be done, but every little thing counts. And this association is there just doing that.
And as you're saying that it's not making a huge dent, I am thinking, when you pay for school for someone, that's huge. Because education is what can take you to the next level. And as you know, the majority of Haitian people in Haiti are not well educated.
No.
Therefore, when you can support education, it's really good. And as you're saying that, I do something. I am a certified trainer for a course that is coming up. That I'm not going to be the one teaching it. The original person who created it, Gary Keller, who is the owner of International, and I'm going to be offering some scholarship to some children.
That is absolutely amazing.
Because education is the best gift I believe you can give. That's huge. I admire you and your friend for studying this, and then everybody that's involved.
And we do that. I mean, for 6-7 years, I got together with my ex-husband and we sponsored 3 boys for a long time. And it's what? About $200 a month. So that was 3 boys. Mm-hmm. And out of that $200, it not only paid for their schooling, but it paid for supplies. It paid for everything. And these boys got to go to school and they were so appreciative because every single school in Haiti is privatized. So you need to pay the tuition every month. And if you don't have that money, it doesn't sound like a lot. So if you're only sponsoring just say one child, that would be $40 or $50, which is nothing. Mm-hmm. And we can think about those things, and it's going to make such a difference for these kids who can go to school. I remember one day, the mom of one of these kids came back and told me, "Oh, you know, there's a child that got killed in front of the school because he got kicked out. He had to go sit on the outside wall until his parents came to get him, and a car came crashing in. Why did he get kicked out? Because no money to pay for schooling that day."
That's terrible. What a tragedy.
He was 2 months behind, and he ended up getting killed because his parents didn't have money for school. So
what a tragedy.
Imagine the difference you can make with just $50 that's going to McDonald's these days.
Yes.
The other day we stopped at McDonald's because we were really trying to go somewhere else, but we ended up stopping at McDonald's. There was 5 of us. It was like $28 for McDonald's.
Yes.
So yeah, it's something that makes all of the difference.
Yes.
So sponsor a child, guys. Think about that. Just one. You never know the difference that you're going to make in their lives.
Because that one can go back and do something else or influence someone else. That's how it works.
I did was to make sure maman de wepanea chaque mois, okay, to make sure that they were sending the kid to school. Maman de pouye popikanea chaque mois. Pour yo parler, pour yo montrer moi, qui ça yo fait, ok, qui ça y apprenne. Et puis,
that's accountability.
That you make sure, because you can, sometimes, okay, that's even, because you think about it, that makes a difference in the parents' lives too. So they might be like, "Oh, well, I'm not really going to send that kid to school." So you go the extra step. Mande pou wekane a chaque mois. Mande ti moun nan parler avec qui ça pour 5-10 minutes.
Yes, and that's good because accountability is powerful. When you are accountable to someone, when you don't feel like doing what you must do, you're gonna say, "Oh, I have to report, therefore I must do this, I must do that." it takes it to another level, and as an
adult,
you know that, you know.
Like how they're going to be, so you're just like, okay, I better see what you're up to.
I get it. Accountability is huge in anybody's world. It's huge because I have coached business people, and without accountability, it's a different world for anybody, really. It's like the mind doesn't think the same. When you're accountable, you step up, You have more opportunity to step up. I totally understand that. And so where do you see your business in the next 10, 20 years?
Hopefully to get, I'm working towards making it a $100 million business. Why not? Why not?
Like
worldwide.
That's a great goal, because what did Steve Jobs said is the crazy one. The crazy one with the crazy idea that one person can change the world.
Right.
Yes, absolutely. So when you think big, because if you, like I just mentioned Gary Keller here, Gary Keller is a self-made billionaire. And he said, you have to aim high, because when you aim low, you're going to go lower.
That's right.
You aim high, if you aim here and you reach there, you're good. You know, you got to aim high.
When I just started, a friend of mine told me that I was still living in Belgium, and he has his own business, and his wife, he and I were thinking of starting businesses, and we were just talking, and he asked us, well, how much money do you want to be making? And of course, his wife answered, I don't know how much she answered. I said, oh, I would just be happy with $5,000 a month. He's like, what? Then don't even start.
No, that's too small, because you cannot be open a business.
It was like, don't even start. What are you talking about?
That was good advice. You know,
that's ridiculous.
Yes, because you have to, because you have to aim high to reach. I totally understand your friend. They gave you, that was good advice. Don't even stop.
It was great advice.
Yeah. So I want to, I so appreciate having you here, and I want to know, how can we, support your business? Where can we find you? If anybody that was watching right now, because we have about 1300 people, and I have some that I'm going to add, and I hope we can increase the group and support each other. So how can we support you?
So, whatever your needs are, if you believe in anti-aging, depending on your age, we have something for everyone. We have for acne. We have a mango butter. If you want to support us that way to help out not only us, but also to help the kids that I told you about from the foundation in Haiti. I know people use body lotion. We've got a mango body lotion that I purchased the mango butter from Haiti. And any part of your body that needs to be moisturized, think about us, support us, because when you support us, you are also supporting your community.
That is true. That is true. And I know you have a lot in your hands. You're wearing many hats right now. So is there... You said you have stores in Haiti. Are you looking to open different
places? We are in stores already.
Okay.
There's a store called Kiani in Rue Auger that carries all of our products. It sells very well. Also in several spas. We are also at, I forget the name of that hotel. It's right on Rue Panamericaine, but we have our products there as well. We've got them all over in Pétionville, so you can find them very easily as well.
So people in Haiti can find your product. That's great. So now to conclude, there are two questions I'm going to ask you, and I would like for you to use just one word for each answer. Okay? Ready?
Okay.
So what's the one word you can describe your life?
One word to describe my life. It is fulfilled.
That's a good one. That's a great one. Because fulfillment, I believe, that's what we're here for. What we're here for. And one word to describe Haiti.
Hope.
Hope. We do need that. We do need that. We do need that. Et quel conseil que tu peux donner à tous les Haïtiens? That can be a sentence. It doesn't have to be one word.
De ne jamais être découragé. de ne jamais être découragé.
Yes, because when you think it's not going to change, then you give up and you cannot give up. It has to change because nothing lasts forever.
Yeah.
And on that note, thank you. It was a pleasure.
Thank you, Isabel. I appreciate it.
Merci beaucoup. And we're going to post your information right here on that same page where we have that, your link. Do you have an Instagram as well?
Yes, it's all Morgana's Alchemy. It's the same. It's very easy. Follow us, you know, like, share the post. We appreciate that. And, you know, also use our product.
Yes. Okay. So make sure we'll post everything here for you guys. And any questions you have for Maya? Contact Maya. She gave you her information. Thank you, Maya.
Thank you. Bye-bye. Have a good night. Okay. Bye-bye.
Thank you, everyone. Bye-bye.